Hello everybody and welcome back to Chellington 17. So we're back in Field 11 today. I don't think we're going to do anything here because we have got to do the vote for the next episode. So what would you like to see us doing in the next few episodes of Chellington? The first option is to bail Field 11, that is this field just here. And that would be with a round baler, the one we have in fact just here. So that is option number one. I'll just get this hitched onto here, and then I'll show you option number two. Option number two is to mow field number 20. Sorry, I just got a bit waylaid here, because I saw a train coming. Whoosh! This is it, field number 20. So option two is to come and cut this. I'm not sure what we're going to do with it yet. It could be hay, it could be just grass bales, I'm not too sure. Or we could just pick it up with a forage wagon. Not really decided. But yeah, option two is just to come and cut this with the Pottinger. I think it's... Is it Pottinger Nova Cat? Yes, the Nova Cat 302ED. So that is what we'd cut this with, which may take a little while. Option number three is to seed field number eight. Field number eight isn't that big and it wouldn't take very long because we've got a relatively large seeder. And we've got two tractors at least, which are pretty high horsepower. So this would be a very quick job. Anyway, those are the three options. Please get voting. And it'll either be tomorrow or the next day when we start the winning suggestion. For today, however, we do need to head back to the farm with this baler. Even if we are going to bale this field, we still need to have this baler at hand today because that is going to be one of the jobs. Now, just tilt these spikes down a bit. We don't want the front loader too high or too low. That's probably okay. So off we go. There is a pasture very close to the cows, and what I'd like to do today is cut it. I don't know if we're going to pick it up with a forager or if we're going to bale it, but either way we need to get from field 11 back to the farm. We could teleport like I was just doing, but we need to have a bit of realism here. So we'll drive back with the Vultra. This being the Vultra N series, I think. Nice tractor. But I've had a few little suggestions about changing the colour. Some people don't like it. It's actually the Fendt colour. Fendt green. We could respray it, but I think at the moment it's a bit of a waste of money. We have only £7,000 or just over. So we're going to have to find another thing to spend the money on for the time being. Just noticed the baler was still unfolded, but it's fine. I wasn't sticking out too far. Ah yes, field 18. Whoa, field 18 we will be cutting. But when we have a bigger mower. There isn't much chance of me doing it with the small Nova Cat because that small Nova Cat is minute. It's fine for field 20, but not for field 18. Very big drop just there. Gets me every time. And this field on the right hand side, field number 6, that is planted and we do own it, so at some point we're going to harvest it. It's just the reason why I haven't done it is because in the 15 series I did that first of all. So we've seen this field here harvested many times before, including a maize harvest for silage. Right, best place for this baler, not too sure. Probably down here. But it can't go too far as we may be using it today. You'll be okay there. Just for the time being. In fact, actually, yeah, we will be using it today, I'd have thought. So we'll leave it all like that. And we'll try... Oh, there it is. The Nova Cat mower. So at least we don't have to go on a hunting mission just to find it. We could use the bulldozer. Or probably not, actually. I think that was ported out of Stalker. We need to get another tractor, though. I really wanted the old Fendt. I'll show you it again. Right at the end of here, it should be. There it is, the Farmer 300 LSA. but obviously we can't afford it, so we're just going to have to wait. Or we could replace another tractor with it. But I think probably a good tractor to mow with might be the JCB. It's obviously a big tractor for the job, but it'd be okay. Oh yeah, we've got these bales. Well, I did have many suggestions before about unstrapping it before we try and sell it, so I will do that. We'll take the straps off. There we go. But I just don't get the feeling that this is the sell point, because there's no straw on the ground. So we shall see. I'll save it first. It might have been worth keeping the straps on first of all, actually, in case they'll fall off when I'm taking it down, but we'll see. Right, okay. I'm pretty sure it was N before to lower it, but doesn't seem to do anything anymore. Okay, it's X. Are those top bales going to fall off? Yes. Oh no, almost. No, I don't think that is the sell point. I think it's been moved to a different place. I'll have a quick hunt about. But, yeah, I think it's moved. Aha! That looks like a likely place for the bale sell point. I'll get it lifted up again, and we'll put them in there, and hopefully this time it will sell. Don't fall off, bales. You need to move. Wow, that's quite a bit of weight. Okay, so we're moving around the yard with no straps on the bales. They could all fly off. In fact, they are shifting, so I'm going to have to go very steady here. I think someone's comment from last week was a much better attempt than usual. However, I wouldn't want to see you on the road with it. And I totally agree. It doesn't look very safe, even with the straps on. Having said that, though, they didn't fall off, which is always a bonus. Right, down in reverse. If this isn't the sell point, then I have no idea where it is. It looks like a sell point. We shall see. Aha! There they go. And we've got £246 per bale. I'm going to say that's pretty good. That's not a bad price. Obviously it's nothing like the silage bales, but it isn't silage. So that explains that one. Right, the IT runner trailer will be used again. So I think we'll just spin round and reverse it into the barn there next to the plough. I'll get rid of that, blocking the view a bit. We've already put 0.7 hours on this tractor. It doesn't feel like it. There we go, I think it's fairly square. And now for the mower. Okay, that's not very square at all, but it would do. I do have crop destruction running, and it's good, except I updated it and it now destroys the grass again, whereas it didn't before. So I'll have to try and find a solution to that. Also, this Chellington map has been updated. So, yep, we've now got the yellowy grass texture. We didn't have that before. I think oxygendavid likes that sort of texture colour. Probably because it makes it more obvious where you've cut. But where we need to go is... Well, it's near the pasture. In fact, I think it is the pasture. The reason why we're going to cut it is because it would definitely regrow before we actually get any cows. So it's just a bit of a waste, really. And we need some feed. We can't get the cows without feed. Wow, look at this. When I drove around here before, it wasn't quite so obvious because the colour wasn't yellow. But now it's pretty obvious. Now, what we could do... in fact, what we might do is have the tractor with the baler going directly behind us, or offset slightly, picking all of this up again. I don't know how well it would work. It might work very well, or it could be a total failure. I might give it a go. just cut this first bit, get started. So we can see where it's actually going. Okay. Right. So, back over to the voucher. I should have just done this in the first place, but I didn't really think of it. I've also just downloaded like a texture pack for this baler. It makes it red instead of yellow. Makes a bit of a change because we use this one so many times. The amount of times I've used this round baler. Wow. I've lost count. Unfold it and then we'll be able to set the follow me. However, we'll have to offset it slightly. Not sure by how much, but there will be probably 0.5 or so. Could be half a metre. Right. Oh no, way more. We'll try 2. More than that. Is that okay? Yep, I would say that is fairly central. That didn't work too well. Too busy looking at the voucher and not looking at what I'm doing. Right, so the first time it is going to make a bit of a mess because we're running on the grass, but every time after this it should be okay. The issue I've just thought of, you fool, Daggerwin, is, well, it depends how many bales we're going to get out of this, but if we get a lot they're going to be in the way. So I think what we're going to have to do is just do it ourselves. It's not a very big paddock anyway. The idea was okay, but it has a major flaw in it. Yes, we will have to stop it over here. Has it dropped a bale? It has, and it's in the way. Oh joy. Well, we'll get it back to here again, and then obviously we'll stop it. I'll do it myself. So let it get to there, and let it stop there. You stop there. Good. We will continue. We might have to go in reverse to get past that bale. If it was a front mower, it would have been okay. It's the fact that it's offset, because it's exactly where we need to drive to do the next cut. There is a bale in the road. Push it out of the way, and we can continue. Good. Okay, so I'm going to blast through this, hopefully get quite a few bales out of it. And these are going to be for feed. I would have done it with the forage wagon, but I don't think we have one. And it would have been a waste of money to rent one. We'll come back to that later. Right, now we can do a proper job. It's starting to look okay after a fairly terrible start. Yeah, it's quite hard to see where we've actually been, except for the colour change, but I think we'll be okay. Get it baled and then get the bales moved. And then when we eventually do get the cows or whatever animal it is, we'll be able to give it to them as feed. Which is pretty easy, you just give it to them. This is another one of those jobs where it's fairly easy from the in-cab view. Some jobs in Farming Simulator are quite hard from in-cab, but this one is dead easy. There's that train again. The silent train, although might have heard it that time. But yeah, brilliant map. Can't wait for it to be released for everybody. And I'm not sure what the situation is with the console release, but hopefully it'll be out on console. But we are almost done here. And then get it baled, and we'll probably move it today as well. Get these bales moved. Because they want to be undercover, Just a little bit. Just as long as they're not totally out in the rain, because there could be some rain on the way. We'll have to check the forecast. It'd be neater as well. So that'll give me another opportunity to use the front loader on the Vautra. Slowly getting used to it. But yeah, if I can get the anti-grass destruction mod for the crop destruction, then it will look much better. Because, yeah, a tractor would flatten the grass, but it wouldn't... Well, I'm going to use this word fairly loosely. It wouldn't delete it. It would just, yeah, flatten it, but it wouldn't make it disappear. Now very soon, I'm going to be starting another Let's Play. It's going to be another mod map, a British map, by somebody who, well, relatively new to me actually. Never played one of their maps before, but I've given it a quick tour. The tour video will be out soon, and wow, what a fantastic map it is. Can't wait to play on it. It's going to be a Let's Play, but more will be revealed very, very soon, so stay tuned. Okay, I'm very close to completion here. We have just got the famous triangle left. This triangle is something we get left with nearly every time. Unless you're playing on a base game map, then you probably won't do. Square fields don't tend to do this. Look at that triangle. Just keep easing into it until it's done. Shouldn't take too long. Hopefully this time we'll be able to finish it off. Almost. So close. Come on. There we go. We're done. So we'll fold that up. I'm sure I didn't use the split at the end there. That's been a new feature. And you can see that that is everything completed. If you're watching in low resolution with low bit rate, this could be a bit of a mess of a video. But hopefully you're watching in HD. I think the best place to take this to will be the yard, so let's just go up here. Because technically, this is for the cows, this area. We shouldn't really be cutting it, it's just we don't have any. I don't think, so it'll be okay. We'll put it back in here. Yeah, it'll be fine here. Brilliant. Okay, let's just run back over to the voucher and we will quickly bail this. It shouldn't take too long, I wouldn't have thought, but if we're going to pick them up as well, that'll obviously take a while. We shall see. We might wait until we've got the auto stacker, because when we do field 11, which needs bailing, we're going to auto stack that. So it just depends how many we get. If we only get a handful, we'll move them with the tractor, with the front loader. But if we get loads, I'm going to wait. Off we go. Now I have downloaded the automatic unload mod. I don't know if it's going to work today. It is enabled, so it should do. But as you can see, it's filling up very slowly. So we're not going to get many bales at all. Yeah, it's only 81%. Seriously slow. Right, will it auto unload? Never used it before, so I don't know if you have to do anything. Okay, nope, it's not going to work. Back to the original idea then. I'll do it myself. Yeah, some mods just haven't worked for me. They are enabled, but they just haven't worked. I'm not sure why. What I've just done is restart the game, re-download the mod, and it now seems to be functioning. It says change auto unload delay off. I think we'll keep it off. We'll see how it responds to that. If it doesn't work too well, we'll change it, but I think it'll be okay. There's no reason to have a delay. I suppose if you want to reverse back a bit and change the angle so it doesn't roll away. But if nothing else, it just makes it easier for me and anybody else who is using the mod, because we'd have to keep pressing Y to unload it, or whatever you've got the setting to. Right. Are you going to work? Okay, you're not going to work. Interesting. Interesting. Right, we'll change it. We will change it. What is 1 second? Is it doesn't... Well, I've never used it before, so I could be doing something wrong. I'm not too sure. We'll fill it up again. We'll fill the baler up again. We'll see what happens this time. The auto unload delay is a second, so maybe this time it will trigger it to work. I'm hoping it will do. Here we go again, 80%. Not too far away from full. Let's see what happens this time. We may have to turn the corner. Wow. Almost did it. Okay, that's full. Ah, it's working now. Except I've put it in the wrong place, but there you go. At least it's working. Good, so it looks like you have to put a delay on. It probably acts as the on-off button too. So that is all very good. That's one of the things I don't like about the round baler. You have to keep stopping to unload. Well, you have to stop anyway, technically, but it's just that you have to keep pressing Y to open and close the chamber. I suppose, yeah, if you're looking for realism, like we technically are, then we shouldn't have that mod installed, but I just think it's going to speed the process up. It would be better. I mean, you can't see me pressing Y each time, so I suppose if it wasn't for that thing in the controls saying auto unload, you probably wouldn't even know, and the fact that I mentioned it as well. So here comes another bale. We've got quite a few now. Although it's filling up quite slowly, we do seem to be getting a lot. Here we go. Yep, all working very well. Fantastic. Whoever created that mod needs an award, definitely. It's simple but effective. Let's get back inside the tractor. We don't want to be floating around outside. Like we're on some kind of magic carpet. So yes, I've now got a schedule for Farming Simulator. If you go on my channel, you'll see the channel art. And on there, it shows you exactly what maps I'm doing on each day. It is Farming Simulator every day of the week. But that doesn't mean that I'm not going to be doing other games as well. So some days there will be two videos, Euro Truck Simulator, maybe Spin Tires, that kind of thing. And yeah, just to put it simply, I've kept everything in order. So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Chellington. Thursday, Friday, Saturday is Goldcrest Valley. And Sunday is Sosnovka, which may well change. Not 100% sure what's happening with the multiplayer server at the moment, because obviously I'm a bit disappointed really with some people, but it will be back up, because I can't just get rid of it. It's been such a popular thing, and there's so many really decent players who just want to have fun. It's just, yeah, next couple of days just going to let these people who are so mature to calm down, and hopefully when it's back up again, everyone will be really happy and everything will be going fine. I think really the problem has been there hasn't been any rules. So there will be some more rules coming this way. And before you play on the server, you'll have to read them. If you don't agree to them, then you'll be kicked or banned. Sounds harsh, but to be honest, there's nothing worse than an immature person wrecking the server. Sorry to put it like that, but it's true. Anyway, we can't all stay in doom and gloom. We must continue. Here's another bale. And yeah, we're not too far away from finishing this field. About, what, are we 60% through? It's just the middle. It's going to be really slow in the middle because of that triangle. Okay, so here we are going round in circles doing the triangle. And yeah, there's not so many bales that we can't do this with the IT runner trailer. So we'll pick them up, we'll put them on the trailer, and for today we'll leave them on there. That'd be the best thing to do. Because until we have got some animals, they're not going anywhere. I suppose we could drop one of the bales in the trough, but without having the right amount of animals, it's not going to give the right amount of feed. So that'd be kind of pointless. Yeah, I won't make you dizzy. We won't do all of this on the screen. And then there's just a few bits here and there which need to be collected because, well, they were missed because of the way it was done. And that is the end. Fantastic. Yeah, there's just this tiny bit. And annoyingly, we're very close to full, but not enough. So that's going to have to be next time. Right, so we're going to need the baler possibly in the next episode. It just depends on what everyone votes for. Although we've probably seen enough baling for the time being. So I'll keep it here. I'll keep it in this shed here if there's space. It's like a scrap shed. But at least if I put it in here, I know exactly where it is, hopefully. Although I could still forget. And then we'll go and get the IT runner trailer. We might as well just get it with this tractor. Because now we have the function of strapping them on. It doesn't matter about reattaching. Back in the day when it was, well, FS09, FS11, FS11 especially, when you attach to the trailer, where did I put it? When you attach the trailer, all the bales would just explode and go everywhere. Yeah, put it over here. Sorry, I do that from time to time. I know I've put it here, but I'm so busy thinking about what to say, I just ignore what I'm doing. There we go. But as we've paid for this trailer, we need to make maximum use out of it. And the good thing is, although it was expensive, buying the different attachments for it is going to be so much cheaper than buying whole trailers in the future. So we'll have to keep buying, for example, another grain trailer, because all we have to do is buy an attachment for this and it'll be a grain trailer. Very simple. That's one of the reasons why I love the IT runner. So the best place for it is going to be right in the centre of the field, so we can load it from both sides, and also so we don't have to go too far each time. I would say about here. We will take it off. And here goes. Let's begin to load the trailer. Oh joy. Well, that's not a good start, but... oh, that's alright. Yeah, you got to be square with it. Otherwise it just messes everything up. In cab view might be easy. Not too sure. But basically we're loading from the front to the back. Hopefully they don't roll. And I will have to go out of cab view just to make sure we're level, which we're not. That was terrible. But when we come to do the round bales in field 11, they'll be auto-stacked. So you won't have to sit through any of this pain. Oh, the pain of watching bale stacking. I should think some people enjoy it, actually. Some people like to watch me fail. Like, they watch the videos just to see if I make a mistake. Other people watch for realism. Other people watch to complain. Other people watch because it's fun. There are many different types of watches. But if you're watching, thank you very much for watching. And I appreciate everyone's views every day. It makes it so worthwhile. I think I'm going to have to do a few more comment readouts as well tomorrow, because I've not done any today. They always seem to go down pretty well. Okay, that's bale number 3, and bale number 4 is just here. Actually, there are quite a few. but they'll definitely fit on the trailer. No doubt about that. We could go 5 high if we wanted to, if only we had enough bales, which we don't. In fact, I don't think we'll get a third layer. We might just about get to a double layer. Oh, I was trying to be confident there, but yeah, messed up. Never works to rush it. Okay, here comes bale number 5, I think, which didn't go on the spike properly. Yeah, this always seems to happen. I always seem to speed up. Need to take more time, think about it more. Oh, that's not good. Okay, bale number 6. That's the final bale from this area. So far, so far, okay. Not so good, because it doesn't look incredible. But the fact is, it's going to get it to the yard. So in those respects, it's actually pretty good. Although I don't like saying that myself. I prefer you to give me your opinion instead of any kind of self-congratulations, because I hate self-congratulations, because it makes you sound like an idiot. Right, okay, let's go for this one here. Yeah, the reason why I hate it is because you just sound like a big head. Like, I don't know. Like, for example, if I finish this trailer and it doesn't look that good, and then you say, oh yeah, that's brilliant, that's really good, then people are just going to think, okay, you're weird. I'm bored of listening to you just congratulate yourself. So, yep. That's why I don't try and say stuff is too good. But then other people get the impression that I'm making myself sound too bad. So, you can't really win. I think I'll just be quiet. And this is the third from the end. Just 2 more for the bottom layer. I tell you something though, one thing which really does help is having flat ground. If you don't have flat ground to do this on, that's when it's harder. Oh, is it just 2 bales left? Oh wow, it's just 1 layer then. Get into the swing of it. Now, one thing I do want to discuss, which I'll be doing loads more information on soon, is the Christmas special, which I'm sure a lot of people are looking forward to. Now, last year, I recorded it on December the 23rd. This year, I'm not going to record it that late. It was just way too chaotic. So it'll probably be around the 18th or something. So not too far from now. This is messed up. I have messed up. In fact, oh no. No, 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 no. In case everything just catapults into the sky, I'll strap them on. I'll have to leave those as they are. That's a shame. That is a shame. Aw, oh well. Yeah, I'm going to have to just sort this out first. But yes, regarding the Christmas special, what we're going to do is we're going to have half the farm as maize and half the farm as poplars. So we're going to do like a massive maize and poplar harvest. Having said that though, we won't be harvesting every single field in the video. Probably just 3, 4, 5 maybe. But it'll still be super fun. And also, very good news for everybody, I have just bought a brand new computer costing quite a bit of money. I'm not going to custom build it because I found a brilliant deal for an incredibly high spec PC. So very soon there will be a new PC. And here is the final bale. I've strapped that one on just so it doesn't fly off. Oh dear. Oh dear. Maybe this time it'll fit? It's a bit of a squeeze, but hopefully. Yeah, just push it on a bit. Please stay. Please stay! Oh no! Right, strap. We have to... It's not recognising it as a strap. That would do. There we go. Good. Okay, so it's done. We have managed to get it all on one layer. In fact, that is the perfect number of bales. And this is going to be for feed, as I have probably already mentioned. In fact, I have already mentioned. All we need to do is wait until we can actually afford the animals, and then we'll be able to do the animals. But that is going to be in the interactive poll, as usual. So before that, we have to do one of the three jobs I've already suggested for today. So once field 11 is baled, or once field 20 is mowed, or once field 8 is seeded, we'll then be able to possibly focus on the animals. But they'll be in another poll next week. So it might not win. We might still not be doing them. Just depends what the majority of everybody wants. Anyway, there is a very good shed just up here for us to put this in. Turns out it isn't the bale sale point, so we can just use it as a store. Where the Matty Ferguson is. Although, even though the straw bales didn't sell here, I will save the game first. The last thing I want after all that is for all of these bales just to sell. That would be hilarious, but also very frustrating. There we go. Good. So this tractor is going to need a wash at some point. Maybe it'll rain. We shall see. But that is it for today. Hopefully... Stop it, rocking tractor. Hopefully you've enjoyed the video. And I will return tomorrow with the next episode of Chellington. Until then, see you again soon. Bye for now.